Okay, so let's start creating a virtual device in this lecture. So go to the file if you have not already started new project. So just click on basic activity, click on next, and we are just again creating the base new project. Click on finish. So trick here is, if you want to open and create virtual device, you can click on these tools. But you see that right now it's not visible because you need to wait until the build is finished here. So Gradle sync started, and you can see that two processes are running. Until unless all the processes completed running, you will not see an option to create a virtual device. Okay, so you have to wait. You see that it's still going through some indexing resources. Perfect. So once everything is done, you will not see any process running here, and you will also see that build is finished. And then try to open tools again, and now you see that AVD manager, SDK manager, these two options are displaying now. Okay, so this is one of the common question I get from students. They will not wait until all the process have been run here and waiting for a message build is finished, and then when they try to open this, they will not find this option. But hang on, wait for a few seconds. Once everything is done, then click on this AVD manager. What is AVD manager? AVD stands for Android Virtual Device. So if you're still wondering why we are using virtual device, this is the place where you automate your Appium test cases. We create a device virtually on our machines, and we deploy the app which we need to test on that device, and we automate it using our Appium tool. Perfect. So when you click on that AVD manager, for the first time, you will not see any devices here. You are seeing this because I already created, but when you start creating this for first time, you will see empty window here. So click on create virtual device, and so this is the first screen. It will ask you on what type of screen you want. Okay, so select any one screen or mobile device for Android and then click on next. So basically, it creates you a virtual device based upon the device you select here. Okay, that particular size, ratio, and density based upon the selection what you made here. So select anything, click on next. And now, so these are the different system images, basically Android operating systems which you want to deploy into your device. So these are different things available. Select any one of the Android target 9 or 9 plus. Okay, and then when you click on next, this particular image, that means this particular operating system, will be installed in your virtual device. So it have an option to download, because right now we don't have any operating system of Android present in your machine. So simply click on download, and that will help you to download the operating system. And once it is done, you can successfully use that operating system and click on next. So which OS to select, it's up to you. Okay, you can see the versions. So right now we are somewhere on Android 9 plus. By the time you are watching this video, you might see some Android 14 or 15, because every month they release new versions. So that really doesn't matter what version you use. Use whatever the latest is available. Okay, so I'm just pausing this video instead of waiting till 100% is done. Perfect. It's done. So click on finish, so that particular operating system is ready in your machine and you can use that in your virtual device. Click on next, and you can give any name to your AVD. So I can say Rahul emulator, something like that. Give one name, but remember this name, because with this name we will invoke this virtual device in our later lectures. Okay, so this is the screen width, dimensions, pixel 2, and this is the operating system version. And when you start, you are saying that start in portrait mode. Now, there is something called advanced settings. So here, you need not worry about much factors, but if you want to change any hardware skin, something like that, you can do it here, but I don't suggest you to change any of this setting. Okay, so this looks good. So we will quickly go back to hide advanced settings and click on finish. And that will create you the new Android virtual device, that is Rahul emulator. So you can start that device by simply clicking on this play icon. You can see that launch this AVD in the emulator. So select this icon and that will invoke virtual device in your machine. Let's see that. You can read the console here, starting AVD. And that's it. The device is open. Where it is? Here you go. You see that it's booting up. For the first time, it might take some time to boot operating system in this AVD. Give some time for this to load up. And within 1 or 2 minutes, you will see that everything is set on this emulator. Okay, so this is how you can create Android virtual device from Android Studio. Hang on, it's trying to boot up. You can see that there is one screen, one line. It's representing that loading all the operating system into this emulator. Now, so going forward, if you want to open this emulator, either you can open this Android Studio, come to the tools, click on this AVD manager, and you can simply start it from here. This is one way. And also, Android guys have given us some commands where you can start this emulator directly from your command prompt. You need not open Android Studio every time. Okay, because this will consume some memory in your machine. So opening virtual device itself becomes your system little slow, because you are booting up another complete whole mobile in your system, right? So RAM takes that effort and that makes your system slow. So you can open this emulator from command prompt as well. So let me show that how to do this. Meanwhile, emulator also booted up. You can see that it's just the same what you can see in your Android mobile. Okay, so we have simultized everything as a virtual device, and we will deploy the apps into this device and we will try to automate them. So that's the idea. Okay, so now remember the names of devices you created. In my case, it's emulator-5554 and Rahul emulator. These are the two different emulators I have in my machine. Okay, so now close everything. Close your emulator, close your Android Studio, and now go back to the command prompt. From command prompt, with a command, we can also invoke the emulator. So whenever you want to do automation with Appium, as I said, you need not open Android Studio every time. First time it is mandatory to create virtual device, there is no other option. But once you create virtual device, thereafter you need not open the studio. You can directly do it from command prompt. If there is something wrong with commands, then feel free to open the Android Studio and then open your emulator. Okay, now go to your Android SDK installation. Let me take you there. As you know, that Android Studio SDK, specific SDK, will be stored in the app data. This app data may be in invisible mode in all our systems. So go to this specific URL box and type this app data after your system name. and then you will be navigated here. So click local and then Android SDK, and then you have a folder called emulator. So this is the .exe file which help us to invoke that specific emulator. Here virtual device and emulator both are same, don't confuse. In Android terminology, it will say virtual device, which is nothing but AVD, and it may also say as emulator. Okay, both refers to same, so do not confuse on that. First go to that path wherever the emulator directory is present in your system. Thereafter you need to provide this command emulator, and what is that virtual device name? AVD. Okay, AVD stands for Android virtual device, and you need to give that virtual device name. Okay, so whatever you created. So I have two virtual devices in my machine. One is emulator -5554 and the Rahul emulator, which I just created. So if I want to open this emulator -5554, so give the command emulator -ad space, give the name of your emulator. That's it. Click enter and that will open. You will get this message that hacks is working, and you see that the device is opened. So this is one way, and here we did not interact with Android Studio at all. Okay, you can close this and you can again close this emulator, and if you want to open it again, emulator AVD and the name of your emulator. Spelling mistake. For the first time it might take some time in your machines to load, thereafter it will be fast. Okay, so this is how you can open your Android virtual device. These are the different methods available. It's up to you which one you choose. Alright, so that's all I have in this lecture. We will proceed with further installations in our next lecture. Thank you.